Good morning, everyone, and welcome to Thursday Morning. My name is Stephen Whiteside from theuptrend.com, and in this presentation, we're going to take a look at just how weak the Dow Jones Industrial Average is at the moment. Now, earlier this morning, I did a video on Bitcoin, and the markets have changed a little since then. They're pretty flat at the moment. Dow futures are up 17. We've got the NASDAQ futures down 40. Looking at commodities, crude oil is up slightly. Gold is down slightly on Thursday morning. Now, earlier this morning, I did a video on Bitcoin. It is up in the pre-market this morning. It is up not enough to give us a buy signal at this time. Now, it is up over 9.5%, and that might seem like a lot, but the average true range for Bitcoin is at 11.52%, which is rather high, would be a very, very volatile stock if it was actually a stock. In dollar amounts, the average true range, the difference between the high and the low on an average basis, is currently at $4,191. We're up $3,290, so this is not a big day, even though it sounds like it's a big day, but for Bitcoin, it's not really a big day. So no need to get overly excited. It certainly fits in with our theory that we're putting on in a bottom right now and we are turning around. But from what we're seeing in the pre-market this morning, it's not enough to get us into Bitcoin just yet. Next up, let's take a look at the overall U.S. market. The Dow has failed to retest the recent high and is currently ranked an 8 on our panic zone chart. Compare that to the Spider ETF, which is ranked in 9, so is the NASDAQ 100 Qs. And then we've got the iShares for the Russell 2000, also ranked in 9. And then the iShares for the microcap sector ranked at 10 right now. Now, speaking of those last two ETFs, we've got the microcap stocks up at the highs from back in March. And they pulled back yesterday, so that gave us a bearish reversal day. Did not close below the previous day's low, so we're not going to get overly concerned just yet. And that is also true for the iShares for the Russell 2000. Now, when we look at the Dow Diamonds, they traded down towards the lower channel line yesterday. Did not close there. We got down, closed at 344.79. We need to close at 344. Below 344.44. We're up 63 cents in the pre-market, so down $1.55 yesterday. So not looking for a sell signal from what we're seeing in the pre-market on Thursday. Things could change. There's some economic numbers coming out that could screw us over. So we'll just have to wait and see. Yesterday, we said we remain short-term bullish on the market as long as the VIX closes below 18.85. Move ahead a day. The upper channel line continued to move lower while the VIX moved higher. So on Thursday, we're going to remain long, short-term bullish on the market as long as the VIX does not close above 18.65. So just the lower channel line has come down a bit, but certainly there's a possibility for a buy signal for the VIX on Thursday. Next up, let's take a look at the Dow 30 stocks. And the point of this presentation is just to show you that the underpinnings of the market are rather weak at the moment, and the headlines are kind of deceiving. There are certainly some stocks that are winning at the moment. We'll take a look at those first, but then one-third of the Dow 30 is not winning at the moment, and that should be a concern to everyone. Obviously, it's not a concern to the market on Thursday morning, but we'll just wait and see what happens in the not-so-distant future. But, you know, when you're looking for a stock that's been winning, it's been trading from the bottom left-hand corner to the top right-hand corner, and there's a whole bunch of Dow 30 stocks that are doing that. That's why the index is up near all-time highs. So you're looking at American Express, Chevron, Cisco, Coca-Cola, then Dow, Goldman Sachs, Honeywell, we've got IBM, we've got JP Morgan, we've got 3M, we've got McDonald's, then we've got Travelers Group, and then Visa. All of these stocks have been doing very well, trading from the bottom left to the top right. Now, one-third of the Dow 30 stocks are actually stuck in the flypaper channel. And if you're really, really bullish, you know, that's an opportunity for those to break out and head up to the top right-hand corner of the screen. If you're really bearish, that's a bad sign. You're looking for them to break down and make lower lows. Of course, we won't know which way the market's going to go until it does make that move, either breaking out to the upside or breaking down from where it is right now. But here are the dogs of the Dow, and as I mentioned earlier, there's no Dow stocks that are completely wiped out at the moment. So we've got Amgen, we've got Apple, we've got Disney, we've got Intel, Merck, and then Nike. All these stocks are stuck in the flypaper channel. We've got Procter & Gamble, we've got Verizon, then Walmart. And last up, Home Depot, which is now back to the flypaper channel after having a huge run in March to May, a two-month run, making a new all-time high, and then we've broken down and traded back to the flypaper channel. Now, if this stock is going to remain bullish, we should look for buying opportunities off the flypaper channel. Out of this list, this is the one that I would be watching the most, and then Apple after that to see if it can break out of the flypaper channel. But 10 of the 30 stocks in the Dow 30 are not looking very healthy at the moment. And I think that's a major point you need to keep in the back of your mind and not just focus on what the headlines are every day, as a lot of the major indices have been making all-time highs. Okay, folks, that is all for this morning's presentation. Have a great day. Next time you'll hear my voice is on Friday morning. And on Friday morning, we'll take a look at North American gold stocks.